Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see a very famous, very commonly used a sorting technique called insertion sort. So insertion sort is the one which we use everyday life. Whichever may be the cases, if you want to sort certain kind of numbers, pages, purpose, whatever it may be, we'll be using this insertion sort. So let us see how does it work. So insertion sort, built on one element at a time. We are going to sort one element. So what we do is, initially we are going to divide the given elements or whatever may be into two parts. One is sorted, other one is unsorted. So what happened is, from unsorted part, we are going to take out one element and we are going to put in the sorted part. Before we see how does it work, so let me make it clear. So in terms of efficiency, this is less efficient compared to the quick sort and heap sort. Quick sort, heap sort and merge sort is having more efficiency than insertion sort, but insertion sort is the one which we use our day-to-day life. Fine. So let us see how does it work. So as I told, the given array, the given elements are divided into two sets. One that stores stored values or sorted values, other one is unsorted values. So the sorting algorithm will proceed until there are no elements in unsorted set. Till you complete every element in unsorted set, this is going to repeat. So every element has got its own index value. So based on the index value, this is going to work. So the first element of unsorted partition has an array index of 0. So please don't take it as the sorted and unsorted having the same index value. So sorted is having one index value and unsorted is having another index value. When you see the next slide, you are going to get better idea about this. So let us start. During every iteration, what we do is we are going to pick one element from unsorted array and place in the sorted one. But when you take it out, you have to see that the element which is just picked up is inserted in the right place in the sorted one. Let me repeat, the given elements are divided into two parts. One is sorted, other one is unsorted. So what we do is we are going to pick one element from unsorted and place in the right place in the sorted array. So let us have a look at how does it work. So as I told, the given elements are divided into two parts. One is unsorted and sorted. And if you look at this diagram, during the first cycle or before the first cycle or first phase, the sorted part does not have got any element because that is empty. We have not started the procedure actually. So we have to start with the first element. So first element, you have to take it out from the unsorted one and place it in the sorted array. So we have done it. So this being the first element, we have no difficulty in this. Now what we do is, so we have to continue like this. After doing this, you have to find out the next element in the unsorted array. Look at the thing. So we have done this successfully. Once it is done, we should go to the next element. So which is the next element in unsorted array, which is 20. So this should be placed in the right place, should be placed in the right place in the sorted array. So when you do it, you will be getting like this. So we have two elements. This is sorted and this is unsorted. Now again, you have to repeat with the next element. You have to find the next unsorted element in the array and place in the right place. Can I place it here? No, because 10 is lesser than 20. So this is not the right place. So then I will compare with 15. Again, 10 is lesser than 15. I cannot place it here. So I'll go to next thing. So this should be placed over here. So when I do it, I'll be getting a 10, 15 and 20 is going to be there in the sorted array, and in unsorted array we'll be getting 30, we have 40, you have a 5 and 45, and you have to continue this. Next, you have to continue with 30. You have to find the right place for this and insert it. So let us see the actual algorithm for this. So we have taken the algorithm as insertion sort. Array is nothing but the complete set of elements. N is number of elements, and repeat step number 2 to 5. So this is step number 1, and this is step number 5. This is step number 5. And initially what we do is set temp is equal to array of k, and it says k is equal to 1 to n minus 1. So initially we'll take k is equal to 1, set temp is equal to array of k. So if you take this is the index value starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, this is going to have 4, this continues like this. So what we do is we are going to take out the first element. So array of k is going to be 1. So this is going to be temp is going to be array of k. Array of k is going to be the first value, which is 10. So this is going to be stored in temp. So go to the next step, set j is equal to k minus 1. This is not temp, is not 10, it is actually 15. Now look at this statement, j is equal to k minus 1. What is your k? K is 1, 1 minus 1 is going to be 0. Repeat while temp less than or array of j. What happened? What is there in temp? Temp is 15, array of j is nothing but, no, this is 20, right? Array of j is j value is 0, so this is 15. So we are going to compare 15 and 20. So this condition fails because 20 is not lesser than 15. So this condition fails. So you have to increment. So you have to increment your k and j. If it is 2, you can enter the loop. Otherwise, you should go to the next loop. So what we should do is we have to increment your k. So initially, k was 1. Now k is going to be 2. It will go to the next iteration. Set temp is equal to array of k. So this is index value 0. This is 1. This is 2. So look at this statement, array of k. So let me make it as array of 2 will be stored in temp, which is 10. Set j is equal to k minus 1. K minus 1 is going to be 1. Repeat while temp less than array of j. What is there in temp? Temp is 10. Array of j. Array of j is nothing but you have to start with 20. You are going to compare it whether this is true. Yeah, it's true. If that's the case, what you do is array of j plus 1 is equal to array of j. So what you do is you are going to move this j plus 1. What is your j? J is 1. So 1 plus 1 is going to be 2. So at this place, you are going to move this array of j. What is there in j? J is 20, and 20 will be stored here. This is going to be 20 now. Next, set j is equal to j minus 1. Next, you have to repeat with the next element. J minus 1 is going to be 0. Repeat while temp, temp remain as it is, array of j. What is array of j? Array of j is, look at this, array of j, j value is 1. So this is going to be, you have to take the next element. So 1 minus 1 is going to be 0. This is going to be 15. You have to compare this. Compare whether 10 is less than 15. Yes. So set j plus 1. So j plus 1 is going to be 1. At this place, you are going to store what is in j. What does it mean? This will be shifted to the next place. So you will be getting 15 here. Set array of j plus 1 is equal to temp. You are going to repeat this. No, you cannot repeat this. It will go to next iteration. So you are going to take it as k is equal to 3. So finally, what happens? You are going to insert the element over here. So when you